Okay, so write down estimation of so this experiment write down is used to calculate the size of a molecule. So I am going to introduce a method in which you can use to find out the size of oleic acid molecule. What is oleic acid? You know that?
Some organic acid. Yeah. Is this the one we just found in olives?
No.
No? Okay.
Could be actually, could be. I'm myself not sure about it. Okay. So this is one of the organic acid. It has two COOH groups. Okay.
So COOH,
right?
That's
oleic
acid.
I'll just tell you. Oleic acid is C18H34 right now. C18. Yes. Okay, this is the oleic acid. So why we have taken such big molecule? Because it will be slightly bigger to deal with. If you are taking a very small molecule, then it becomes, you know, impractical for us to use this method to find the size of it. Okay, so we have used the bigger molecule. Okay, in this experiment. Okay, write down. So what you do is that you dissolve one centimeter cube. Of oleic acid into 20 meter cube of water. Okay. Why we have used not 20 meter cube of water, in fact 19, so that the total solution is 20. Or you can say you are dissolving 1 centimeter cube of oleic acid into water so that it makes a total of 20 meter cube of solution. Okay. Now tell me, can you answer like why we are using oleic acid molecule? Why not some other organic molecule which is big? It is soluble in water. It's polar. So you can get solid. It is soluble in the water.
One centimeter cube in 19 meters.
Yes.
Yeah, it's 1 centimeter. So it's like
19.9999999.
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Okay. Then you have a solution like this. Suppose this is 20 ml of this solution. Okay. After that, you have seen the dropper?
Yeah.
Have you ever used dropper to fill the ink pen?
Yeah. Yes.
So you have this dropper, you press the dropper, put it inside, you take some solution inside the dropper, okay? Then you have an empty, you can say test tube or whatever, and you drop n drops of this. You're dropping n drops of this solution over here. So there are n drops of the solution. Getting it?
Yeah.
Understood? These are n drops of this solution. Okay. Now what you're doing is, you're again diluting it up to 20 ml of mark. You're putting water so that it becomes 20 ml of solution. Understood?
Yeah.
Okay. It becomes 20 ml of solution. So what is the total dilution over here? Suppose one drop.
1 by 20.
1 by 4.
Molar.
One drop has a volume of V. So how much of total total volume of this solution inside this?
N into V.
N into V?
Yeah.
Okay, which was anyway diluted up to 20? This divided by 20. So this is the, let us say, meter cube of the oleic acid divided by the total volume of the solution. This is how much it has diluted. NV divided by 20 by 20. Okay, you have diluted it by 20 times initially. Then again you diluted 20 times. So total dilution is 1 by 400. And into N into V. The N into V drops. Okay. This experiment is slightly weird, but then this is how it is conducted. It is a need to do like this. Okay. We'll first conduct the experiment, then we'll come back and understand why we are doing it like this. Okay. So this is the procedure. First you dilute it to the 20 meter cube, then you take N drops in empty beaker and again dilute it to 20 meter cube. Okay, right? Now what you're doing is, the volume of N drops of the solution is N into V cube, and amount of oleic acid is NV divided by 20 into 20.
Yeah.
Okay, now this volume NV divided by 20 into 20, you're taking an vessel with larger cross-section area which has water in it. Okay, and then you're spreading some powder. That powder is called lycopodium powder. This is the only chapter in physics. You have to remember a lot of things. But then
so
this is very easy. Okay.
Is that an indicator? Is that a basic powder or an indicator?
First write down, we'll come back to that. Lycopodium powder you are spreading on the surface of the water. Lycopodium powder is an organic powder. It will not get, let's say, it will not get soluble in the water. It will be on the surface. Okay, but there's a porous boundary between the powder and the water. Are you getting it? We are not using a membrane sort of thing, that if there is a lycopodium powder over here, okay, if I put anything on the lycopodium powder, it can touch the water also. It's a porous boundary. Okay, now on that lycopodium powder, you're pouring this. Okay, so what will happen?
It will dissolve in the organic solute.
Huh?
Solvent. So
lycopodium powder will hold the organic part of the oleic acid. Okay, and water will try to hold the polar part of the oleic acid. Okay, so lycopodium powder, you can say it is used as inhibitor for oleic acid to get dissolved in the water itself. Okay, understood? So we are spreading this much volume onto the surface of lycopodium powder. What will happen, that there is a water also, the oleic acid is only NV divided by 400, rest all is water. That will go inside the water itself. Lycopodium powder will not hold the water. Are you getting it? Only this much portion. Suppose you take N into V drops.
Okay.
If you take this much, which is N into V volume,
yeah,
only this much will be held by the lycopodium powder. Out of N into V, only this much is the oleic acid.
Oh, the remaining
will get dissolved in the water.
But shouldn't the oleic acid hold the water which was previously dissolved in it?
No, it's not like that. Oleic acid and oleic acid is dissolved in water, you're correct. But then, water get dissolved with water better than water getting dissolved with oleic acid. Okay? So, the this water will try to form a hydrogen bond with whatever is the water in this volume of the solution, and it will pull it down. And lycopodium powder will hold the this much oleic acid on the surface. Getting it? And it will spread across, let's say, uniformly. And it's a bigger area. Big area is there. So it will spread as much as possible. Okay? The assumption here is, the greatest assumption is that it will, the surface is so large that it will spread as unimolecular layer. Are you getting it? You will spread it, the lycopodium powder, or you will spread it till it will stop spreading. Getting it? And when it will stop spreading, then there is a unimolecular layer. One molecule here, one molecule there. Like this. Suppose there is one more molecule at the top. It can further spread or not? If this layer can come and sit adjacent to it, it can further spread, but after this spreading is not possible. Okay? So this is the biggest assumption, and that is why it is called just estimation. It is not called calculation. It's just a rough estimation. Okay? So using a big beaker, you have spread the oleic acid in such a manner that on the surface, unimolecular layer is there. Okay? Now, how to calculate the diameter of the molecule? Can you tell me that?
Surface area divided by number.
Suppose the area of the beaker is known as A. Can you do it?
Yeah.
Get the expression. Don't talk in air. Tell me what is the diameter of the molecule. Understood? How to go about this? No idea? What is the total volume of oleic acid? How much it is? This much is the volume. Okay? So write down NV divided by 20 into 20. This is the volume of the oleic acid which is spread on the surface. Okay? We know the area of cross section of the beaker. Okay? So this should be equal to area of cross section of the beaker into thickness of the layer. Can I say this thickness is the diameter? That is the answer. This, if you divide this by the area of the beaker, you get the diameter of the molecule.
Thickness
of the oleic acid on the surface, if you assume it to be monomolecular layer, is the diameter of it. See, this is, all of you understood, this is the volume. This is the volume of oleic acid which is spread. Any doubt here? This is the volume of oleic acid which is spread. And in how much area it has spread? Area of A. So this should be equal to area A into thickness of the layer. Right? And it is a monomolecular layer. So thickness should be the diameter of the molecule itself. So area into thickness should be equal to this, because it is oleic acid that is spread across. Getting it? So that is what we have done. We have equated area into thickness with this to get the thickness. And that thickness is your size of the molecule itself. Okay? I can understand your pain. It is not very intuitive. Okay? But then, this is, I think, a very nice method to come up with the, you know, roughly the size of the molecule. It is a rough estimation, but still, you don't get any simpler method than this without using any instrument.
So is it practical, is it possible, practically possible to do it?
Yeah.
It is.
But what
is,
so how
do you reach the monomolecular layer?
What?
How do you know when you reached a monomolecular?
If it stops spreading.
Can you see it spreading, sir? Like,
no, you, there can
the
be.
No,
you can see the layer breaking, no?
Okay.
It's like an oil. It's an organic thing. won't you be able to see the oil on the surface of water?
Or you could just take a large beaker and put one drop of oleic acid until it stops spreading.
Yeah, I did not. So
why
this
you have
so NV divided by 400 is
no. Why, guys, stop talking. Why do we have to dilute it so much?
Reduce the amount of oleic acid.
To reduce the amount of oleic acid is one. But what you are saying that why not just take one drop of the oleic acid and put it over there?
So because
okay.
Yeah, there's really
concentrated.
It's much harder to
first is that it will be concentrated only in the one drop, all of it. So it becomes difficult to spread it. So if you have so many drops, you can put the drops all around, and then it can spread easily. It is nothing to do with, let us say, science of it. Why can't we do it? Definitely you can do it. You can do it on the paper, but when it comes to practically, there are some practical issues. Are you getting it? You don't need to even dilute. You can take one molecule, put it at one place, take another molecule from hand, put it in another place, but practically not possible. Fine? So all these practicals, they are not talking about idealistic scenario. Okay? Even equations like force equal to mass m acceleration is not very accurate. Okay? When you're trying to apply in practical world, things changes, and this is how it is practically. In fact, whatever science you're learning, you're done with the entire science by the time you complete the class 12. In the engineering, you're learning the practical aspects of it. Okay, there comes a lot of difficulty. Okay, I hope you understand this thing. Okay. This is a favorite question in school exams, to devise a method to estimate the small distance, and this is what it is.